Well, it's in the mid-40s, and that sounds chilly because it is, but it's an improvement. At least we're not in the 30s. And we are going to warm it up significantly the next couple of days. The problem is we've got a lot of wind to deal with and also the potential for some strong to severe storms over the next 24 to 48 hours. So just get ready for that. It's 40s here, but there are some 30s. Flemingsburg down in the upper 30s, as well as London. And then you go south and west. Look at Glasgow, still holding on to the low 50s. So let's take the broad view and talk about the wind for a moment. It's out of the southeast, and eventually it's going to come straight out of the south later on today, and it'll start to get gusty. What's happening is, and what you're looking at, is the wind speed at the 850 millibar level. Basically, that's about 5,000 feet up from us. But it gives us an idea of not only advection as far as temperature advection, bringing warmer or colder air in. It also gives us an idea of how broad the wind field is. And right here you can see stronger winds just a few thousand feet up. That's that hole in the atmosphere that is the blizzard out west. So basically the wind's cranking across a good chunk of the United States, and it'll continue to be the case as that low rolls up into the upper Midwest into Thursday. And you notice the wind overhead screaming by, and some of those stronger wind gusts are likely going to mix down to the surface and we'll catch it. So by later on today, here you go. We've got wind speeds approaching, if not exceeding 40 mile per hour gusts, and it could go even higher as you go through overnight hours and into tomorrow. We're still hitting around 40, maybe 45 mile per hour gusts. The peak will probably be tomorrow afternoon, tomorrow evening. This is getting into Thursday. You can see wind gusts hitting maybe close to 50 miles per hour. This is right before the cold front goes through early Friday morning. So that's one factor. The other issue, of course, the storm chance. We've got spotty returns in the max track, some isolated showers, sprinkles, a possibility this morning. Most of the moisture is off to the northwest. But there is that blizzard out west that is just starting to crank up. You can see the snow flying across parts of Colorado. So the blizzard begins, high pressure slides east. One of the reasons we've got that south to southeasterly wind shift this morning. And there's the blizzard warning. It runs from Colorado up into the Dakotas. They are getting hammered, will get hammered with heavy blowing snow. And yeah, blizzard conditions, just nasty, dangerous weather out west. We've got a chance for storms. And we talked about this yesterday, the severe storm threat just kind of marching east as a cold front gets closer. So there's a bullseye of an enhanced risk today down towards Memphis. Tomorrow, we do have a slight risk for severe storms here at home. Basically from Lexington west, and there will likely be a couple of rounds. One gets going and tracks in late this evening. You'll see it rolling in from out west, probably losing some steam as it does. So I do think these will weaken, but it may wake you up early tomorrow morning. And then after a break in the action into the afternoon and evening, it's around dinner time. That's where our better chance for a round of strong storms, maybe some damaging wind gusts, will blow through into tomorrow evening, tomorrow night. The 8-day show's on the back end of that, colder, drier, more quiet conditions going into the weekend. But yeah, that chill settles in from low 70s tomorrow to 50s Friday into the 40s for your St. Patrick's Day weekend.